Now, the easiest way to get to white balance is to go to the cross keys, and the one at the bottom with WB stands for white balance. If you press that, then you can see what options you have. This camera does have very good automatic white balance settings. In fact, it has two. The first one is automatic white balance with ambient setting, which means that it will look at the image through the lens and decides probably what is the color which is most likely to be white. This is very useful because it takes into account the color cast of the scene to give an image close to how we would see it. So it gives you a very natural looking picture. However, if you want a picture with a very stark white, then you can choose automatic white balance with white priority. And that means that the camera will impose a very clean, almost bluish white tone onto the picture. And all the other colours, of course, will follow suit. That often gives a very sterile feel to the picture, with harsh contrast. It does have its uses, though, and this white balance is often used in advertising, and also for pictures which want to present something as very clean and crisp. If we now look at the presets, then using the cross keys, we can go through them. The first one is daylight, and that's indicated here by the icon of the sun. As it suggests, this works with outside daylight to produce natural looking images. It warms up the tone slightly to give the impression more of sunlight and sunshine, and so it gives you that quite warm textured picture. The option next to that is shade, and this is the sort of setting you might use if you're taking a picture of somebody on a sunny day, but they themselves are in the shade, perhaps of a wall or under some trees. The one next to that is cloudy, and again, it's for outdoor shooting. For when it's a very flat and dull day, and it will try to pump up the image and give you a little more vibrant colour. The next two are for indoor shooting, and the first one we come to is tungsten. And this is the sort of lighting that you get in normal lighting when you're in your home. And it tries to counteract that effect, which is a slightly yellowy daylight tone that you get from light bulbs. The one after that is for fluorescent lighting. Fluorescent is the sort of lighting you find in shops and public buildings, often the long strips of light that give off a very blue light. Obviously, we don't notice that. Our brain filters it out, but when you're taking a picture, if you do it on automatic white balance, then you might pick up some of that blue, and it will make the image seem very sterile and cold. So in this setting, it will try to counter that and put a bit of warmth back into the picture. Ah.